Nothing wrong with a bit of Bruce Springsteen. Just before 10 o'clock in the morning. Especially on a Thursday, I find. Dancing in the Dark, that was. If you like your Beyoncé, you're in luck this week because her new album, Renaissance, is the album of the week. Yet another track from that being played in about an hour's time, just over an hour's time. A little bit later than that, you'll hear actor, singer, almost everything else, Claire Grogan, choosing the tracks of her years. And somewhere in between, Robbie Williams will sing Lost. It's the record of the week. And right at 10:30, that'll be time for Pop Master. You know it. Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, your smart speaker, and 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 10 o'clock. This is Anthony Birchley. A report by the police watchdog has said victims of burglary, robbery and theft in England and Wales aren't getting the justice they deserve. The Chief Inspector of Constabulary, Andy Cook, said too many offenders remained at liberty. The National Police Chiefs Council said it would consider the findings and help forces to make changes. The head of the College of Policing, Andy Marsh, said things would get better.
I think the report shining a light on these shortcomings today and highlighting the fact that there are national standards of supervision, there are national standards of investigation that we will work in partnership with chiefs to deliver, should give us significant optimism for the future that this is going to improve.
A British man accused of being a member of an Islamic State cell known as the Beatles has been charged with terror offences. Hein Davis was detained at Luton Airport last night after returning to the UK from Turkey. Here's our security correspondent, Frank Gardner.
The 38-year-old from West London has been charged with a number of offences under the Terrorism Act and is expected to appear at Westminster Magistrates Court later this morning. He has already spent more than 6 years in a Turkish prison after being convicted of belonging to the Islamic State group. He is alleged to be the fourth member of the ISIS gang that tortured and murdered Western hostages in Iraq and Syria, which he denies.
Ministers are meeting energy companies today to discuss ways to help households struggling with soaring energy bills. Experts have warned that the typical annual bill could reach more than £3,500 in October before rising further in the new year. But the government has said there'll be no extra support until a new prime minister is in place next month. The body representing water companies says it's increasingly inevitable that a drought will be declared in Britain. Water UK says firms are working tirelessly to repair leaks to prevent water wastage. Stuart Colville is the director of policy at Water UK and explained why leaks are occurring.
Particularly in hot, dry conditions, what happens is the soil dries out, it cracks and it moves, and that puts additional pressure on the pipes and that can cause additional bursts. So we've got hundreds of people out today and throughout this week, finding leaks, patching them up as fast as possible. I do understand that when you see one in the streets, it can be really frustrating, which is why we're doing everything possible.
Two people have died and a child has been seriously injured after five people were hit by a car in Ramsgate yesterday evening. Kent police said they were all members of the same family. A 30-year-old man from Ramsgate was arrested on suspicion of causing death by dangerous driving and leaving the scene of a collision. And David Bowie has been named Britain's most influential artist of the past half century for his ability to transcend music, film and fashion. He topped the Sky Arts list of 50 names. The runner-up was the Oscar-winning filmmaker Sir Steve McQueen. That's the BBC News at 10:03.
Live on the BBC Sounds app.